Hello and welcome to my reaction to the third episode of Yuki Yuna wa Yusha Dearu Washiosumi no Sho, or the prequel to the first season about the three first girls who were fighting the Vertex, including Washio, which is Togo from season one. Not much to say. The first two episodes were pretty much like the first season. We were introduced to the character, to their fighting. They grow their bond as friends and as a team. They fought some Vertex. But we haven't had any Mankai yet, so we haven't yet seen them go through the realization of the effect that using Mankai will have. You know, losing body function or a body part or something like that. So things aren't too fucked up yet. But as this is only 6 episodes and we're on episode 3, I think shit will get fucked pretty soon. Anyway, as always, I'm using the Kiss Anime version. There is the Kiss Anime intro. Without further ado, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Virus. That's new information. The top. Blank by blank, so we don't get to know yet. Alright. More training. Good music. That's pretty cool. Fair enough. I'm good at that too. I'm great at it, actually. Series, yeah. What? Holy shit, that voice acting. Man, Kana and Azawa really is the best. That's why you're wrong, yeah. That's pretty funny. Banzai. Opening, yeah. Episode 3, Everyday Life. Alright, so I guess nothing about this episode. It does actually. It's pretty good. Damn. It's called Yuri. It's the greatest thing ever. This is way better than before, actually. I really like this one. Holy shit, and this one too. Meh. Yeah, of course. Unpatriotic, because I forgot that she's so obsessed with patriotism. Not bad. Kind of look like a wedding dress. What? But that's a cool outfit. I like it. Yeah, not my thing. Alright. Zuikaku and Shokaku. In truth, I know nothing of the battleship. I only know the Azulene character. Which is kind of sad in a way. Let's talk about dreams, so it's sadder when we know they can't actually come true. It is. Yes, I agree. That's cute. It. A classic, but it always works. Space Sancho. Yeah. I don't think that's how it works. Very later to the episode. Of course. Oh, Gin got it. You know, Gin is really growing on me. I thought she was my favorite because Kenna Anissa was voicing her, but Gin is really cute. Well, that's fine. It's never just. I don't think so. Oh my god, this fucking no sound. The comedy of this episode is really good. I don't like any of the swimsuit, especially. Well, not really, since when you transform, you get your outfit. Someone's playing Twister. What's going on? That's the. You know, this is Japan, so I feel like the probably actually is a real kind of show like that. Which country is stronger? Of course, it has to be 3D. It doesn't really matter. It's for a joke anyway. Indoctrinated the children. I think that's the word. What kind of reaction is that? Get that. Interesting thing that she called in my brother. in English. Small detail, but it's pretty nice, you know. That seems like a goodbye. What's going on? Fair enough. Alright, absolutely nothing bad happened this episode. That's fine with me. What stood out to me this episode was how funny it was. Like, some of the jokes were actually funny, to where I laughed out loud once or twice, which is very rare for me. So, yeah, that was pretty damn good. Especially the voice. I mean, when Kanan, as they were, was coming in the car making that weird voice, or each time Washio was surprised and there was this weird background voice, that was really fucking funny. Otherwise, it was a pretty standard slice of life episode, I guess. Middle point of this prequel. I guess we're giving the character a break before everything goes to shit, like I said. Watching the preview. So yeah, I'm gonna watch the next one. Actually, I'm not sure because if I watch the next one, it will most likely be a serious one. So maybe for today, it might be best for me to just end on that happy note, I guess you could say. I don't know. Nah, I'm gonna watch the next one. So anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.